Now when y'all edit that, when I remove the hand, let it say GQ or some shit. If you you see what I'm saying, that should be the intro to the video. As soon as I go like this and say GQ and just pop out, that should be cold. That'd be cold as hell. I want credit for that too. Like Iman thought of this. I would type it up right there at the top. Iman thought of this. GQ. What's going on, GQ? I'm Iman, and today I'm gonna tell you the stories of my tattoos. With my tattoos, the real story and inspiration behind it is to make the dream world meet the money. I knew that I wanted the worlds to come together in the end, which is why you'll see this smoky, dreamy consistency going through this side. Real dreamy stars to speak on the concept of reaching for the stars. You'll see dice and cards on the flush. You'll see the dice on 7 just to let you know to always take your chances and better yourself. I got the word dream right here, just, you know, a word that I love to look at on a day to day. Black Jesus walking through snakes, just to remind myself that even in your purest form, you still gonna have to walk through some evil shit. I got the 290 sign, just, you know, the highway going to pick my parents up from work, Cartoon Network, all that, Batman. Batman was actually a cover-up for, something that, you know, when you're a kid and you want to just rap something, and, yeah, we covered that on up. 88, Love Not Blood, Love and Basketball. 90 is me and my best friend, Alex Montgomery, played at Georgia Tech on the girls' team. We was the best players there, and we had linked up both being from out of town. So, we ended up getting a matching tat just with all the time we spent together. My oldest tattoo is the basketball. I think like all basketball players got that. It's corny, but it's got a pretty good finish on it. A key to success, I just happen to love it. I always try to live by the principle that I was playing ball for the love and never just for money. I got that basketball at 16. Well, my mom took me and my brother came too. I believe my brother and my mom sketched it out for me. I came up with the design though. I knew I just wanted a basketball. I just knew my mom could make a cooler basketball than most people would draw. This one might be one of my favorites. I made it facing me, but it is a phoenix rising from the ashes. One man that you see, they deem king, but you also see other people are in the hunt for that same power. Somebody's already fell from that power. And you see nameless and faceless people fighting, some bickering, some questioning, some just submitting to seeing somebody else in power. I call it power in the masses. And it's just to speak on the strength of numbers and give you that constant reminder that even if you make it to that top and you're on that platform, even if you rise again, it's never no time to be comfortable in any sort of sport or form of life. Oh, that's my side eye emoji. I don't know. Left arm, the money arm. I put a money tree at the top to represent cash rules everything around me. Money don't grow on trees, but flipping the concept to remind yourself to make it grow on trees for the next generation. Shumpert family crest right here. My auntie Carolyn was really proud to be a Shumpert. And she used to like make me wear it with a badge of honor. Rest in peace to her. I lost her to pancreatic cancer, but she always made me feel proud of my last name. And, you know, she spoke highly on names. She felt like names and presentation of a name meant a lot. So I held on to it so much that I ended up searching for the Shumpert family crest, which I don't even know if it's correct, but I went and got it because it was on Google and they said it. Yeah, I put the staff there, the health staff there, just to bank on something good happening when my aunt was in the hospital. Money consistently falling from that tree. And you'll see the tattoo of me kissing my mother, tattoo of me looking at my father in a mirror. And it's to say, mama's boy, daddy's reflection. I always wanted to be like my dad's junior. I used to like be like jealous of my brother, Paca. I used to like run down on the man and like like try and play him basketball every day, like going in, because I really wanted to be like Otis Jr. on some weird shit. That's something that like little boys go through. They all want to be like dad's favorite type. Like, you get that approval, that man approval. Green Line train system. Between these five stops, it was a lot of my life.
You can find out a lot about me by going through them five stops.
You see Redson, that's my stop, my hop off.
A green eye, keep your eye on that money. You know what I'm saying? That'll give you the size. That's your North Star. Guns and Roses, empty bottles and lick swishers, respect over likeness. Yeah, these are all the ideas that I felt like were behind money and my desire to get to making these two worlds make sense together. The one right here on my chest holds a lot of value to me. I'm my brother's keeper. Me and my brothers we planned for all of us to get it, but I believe just me and my youngest brother got it. Y'all gotta go get y'all's too, R.E.A. and Parker. I'm one of four boys that my mama had. I got my Auntie Carolyn and my godmama Lenny. Here you'll see 839 growing up. I lived on 839 North Harvey. He was like, man, and they came in there and dude just came, he got out the car and he smacked the shit out of dude. We be like, man, that don't happen in 839. I'm telling you now, they don't go down like that in 839. I got a boom box. My heart beat with music. Like, I feel like my whole life moves at the tempo of a song. The 90s head is my brother trying to embody what basketball meant to us. And the reminder of the high top was just a way to put myself, to trick myself into thinking, man, I'm 21 and 94. I'm gonna wear short shorts and have a high top and I'm not gonna fit in. But if you put me in 94, I look like I fit in. I think that'd be cool. So that's what the idea behind that was. And it became a cool little stamp that people got accustomed to. This is like an obvious favorite for me. You see my wife as Nefertiti. You see my daughter as a cherub. And as me and my wife had kids, I left it open-ended to start bringing kids to hang off of each other as well as my wife. Then I got one more. It looks like it says believe, but it really says conceited, but it says it on the flip. So the only way you can read it is if it's in the mirror. The ribs killed me, man. That's the first time I almost gave up on the tattoo. I was gonna just say, you know what? I don't care what it looks like, I'm done. I'm cool. That and this. Ooh. Like, I can refeel this right now. That's how bad that hurt. Other than that, I got my birthday on the top of my back, and the birthday being on there is I want it to look like a movie because it's going to end up being not only my favorite influences but some of the pillars in my family that I've lost. I want to take up my back. I also want a lot of accolades and things that I'm proud of in my life to all appear mural style under my birthday, so that when you finally see the finished product, when I turn, I don't know, 40, 45, whatever, when it's finally finished, it'll really tell my story and look like a movie that came out June 26, 1990. That was the thinking behind it. So that's all my tattoos. Thank you. Oh, I lied. How are we gonna do this, guys? All right, so I got this one, and it actually says just because we were at the tattoo shop for piercings. Junie was drawing, and Junie handed us a paper and said, y'all should get this. And the paper, though scribbled, looked a lot like she was trying to write Iman. Like, she was just trying to write her name, but it had like Iman, but it has like a crown. And then like some scribbles, and then she scribbled through it. And I was like, now, no, I know that I'm her dad. But I'm like, if you told me that Basquiat drew this and he made it for me, I'd be like, oh, that's so cool. It says Iman, and then it's scribbled out like a little kid did it. I want the close up in slow-mo too, that. I'm running out of room, but I do plan to finish my hands up, and I'm thinking about a neck tattoo. So
If you guys stumble across my social handles, you know, on any platform, tell me if I should get this neck tattoo, because I'm thinking about it. Tell me, does it hurt? Is it just a bad business move? Like, have y'all gotten a job out of this? Because after I'm done hooping, I'm thinking about getting a job. Not gonna lie. So y'all just give me something in the comments section or the DM section, whatever. Should I get that tattoo?
Or should it be on this side with the same size as the nose ring? Look. Look at my. Well, guys, that's all my tattoos. Thank you for getting a second to getting to know them. Fire. Lob. Missed shot. Tip.